Okay.
Tamam.
Each of the student, you can directly share your presentation. Jadi nanti Anda masing-masing bisa langsung share sendiri, ya. Oke. Okay? Jadi mohon disiapkan nanti setelah penampilan teman sebelumnya. Kemudian diikuti question and answer session. Jadi 10 minutes itu sudah cover untuk presentation and question and answer. Yes, you may take the floor, Mbak Avelia.
Thank you, ma'am. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, let me introduce myself, Afilia Bayu Ipsaka. I am NPM 44. I am from English Education Program. I would like to thank for the opportunity that has been given to me to present my research with the title is Using Animated Video to Teach Writing Narrative Text for the 10th grade student of SMKN 1 Ngeger in academic year 2021-2022. But the first, I will explain about the background of the study. The background in the study explain that when language learning, one must master four basic skills, namely listening, reading, speaking, and writing. One of the important skills in language learning is writing skill. However, in language learning, it is often found students will have difficulty in writing skill. For example, they are confused about choosing word, they are confused about compiling sentence, and this is can be one of the factor that make students unable to write effective writing. In addition, there are still many teachers who teach with a conventional approach in teaching writing. The English teacher at SMKN 1 Ngeger still apply traditional method in learning where the learning approach in teacher center. In this traditional method, students listen more to the teacher explanation in front of the class. So if this traditional method is applied continuously, the student feel bored in the learning process. So a teacher must be able to provide solution to avoid this, one of which is by using media in delivering material. So the researcher chose animated video as a media in this research that will use to teaching writing. Media that can be used by teacher in learning to write, it is to use animated video because animated video can increase student understanding of a topic discussed so that they can help student receive information. In this research, the researcher focus on the procedure using of animated video as a media in teaching writing narrative text about verbal and the subject of the study were student of class 10 SMKN 1 Ngeger. And then the result of this research, it will be useful for student, teacher, school, and research other. Then this slide is for chapter 3. In this slide, explain about number first is place and time of the research. The research was SMKN 1 Ngeger. It was carried out from April until July. And then the type of the research used in this research using qualitative research. The data searched in this study was the first is participant, social situation, and document. The participant used namely teacher and student in this research. The researcher observed the activity of the teaching learning process of class 10 in SMKN 1 Ngeger and used photograph to know the condition the class during teaching and learning process. The researcher chose student and English teacher of class 10 at SMKN 1 Ngeger as the participant. Teacher also use syllabus, lesson plan, student attendance list, and student grade as material for the data collection process. Then the technique of collecting data, there is something important about technique of collecting data in qualitative research. To collect data, one of them is observe a person's daily activity and analyze document of time. In this research, the researcher used the participant observation method because the researcher also participated in this research. And the researcher used in this method to get data about the list observation of classroom activity when teaching writing to write narrative text using animated video. Before design the instrument, the researcher must take the data first, and in collecting this data, it must be done and must be careful. The main instrument in this research, namely the researcher observation checklist, syllabus, lesson plan, and documentation. The data in this research to know about the procedure of using animated video to teaching writing narrative text. And the technique used in this research is to use the step as analyzing data has three steps, namely data reduction, data display, conclusion, and verification. After analyzing of the data, it is very also important to verify the data to continue the research. Namely using triangulation. In this study, in this research, two stage, namely planning and implementation. In this research, the researcher only focused on the use animated video in teaching writing narrative text, and the researcher displayed data from observation in the form of description so that in the description it can be seen related to the problem content in this research. From the result of the data obtained from observation, it can be now about the procedure of using animated video in teaching writing narrative text for the 10th grade student of SMKN 1 Ngeger. Furthermore, this slide will discuss the result of the data obtained from the observation. The first, in the result of the data from observation, there are two parts. The first is the preparation, and the second is teaching and learning process. At the preparation part in this research, prepare learning tools such as lesson plan, student attendance list, and tool used during learning such as LCD, whiteboard, marker, and so on. Then during the teaching and learning process, there are three activities, namely pre-activity, wheels activity, and post-activity. In this slide, we'll discuss in more detail related to the problem in this research, namely related to the use of animated video in teaching writing narrative text. The use of animated video in teaching narrative text, as explained in this previous slide, in this use animated in teaching writing narrative text, there are three activities, namely pre-activity, wheels activity, and post-activity. First, in the pre-activity, there are several activities. For example, before starting the lesson, the researcher greet the student, then the researcher asks one two student to lead the prayer, then the researcher check the student attendance, and then the teacher give question related to the material to be studied. After that, the teacher explain the learning objective. The second, in the wheels activity, the researcher explain the material about narrative text content in the PowerPoint. After that, the researcher So, animated video related to the fable entitled is The Ant and the Dog. The animated video was played several times, and the researcher also extend again relate to the generic structure according to content of the animated video. Next, the researcher give task to student. Students were also to make Next, the researcher give a task to student, namely the student were asked to analyze the two generic structure and language feature. And then student were also asked to make narrative text according to animated video using their own language. After all the tests has been complete, their answer are discussed together and then collected. And the third or at the last activity is post activity. The researcher give a feedback to the student, followed by giving conclusion for today learning activity. Before closing the lesson, the researcher asked the student if there was anything they did not understand about the narrative text material. And finally, the researcher closed the lesson. Well, that's it for the presentation in this seminar. Do you have any question about my research?
Okay. So how, teman-teman? Dipersilakan, do you have any questions or comments? Ini juga exam practice ya, Mbak? Anda sambil latihan presentasi ujian. Okay, bagaimana teman-teman? Do you have questions or comments about research? You actually jangan di ini dulu Mbak sebenarnya apa share screen-nya. Jadi kan maksudnya teman-teman mungkin masih butuh lihat.
Ini di share screen lagi, Mem.
Oh, ya udah. Enggak apa-apa udah. Dan maksudnya nanti untuk yang selanjutnya ya. Jangan buru-buru dimatikan gitu. Jangan buru-buru dimatikan. Oke, bagaimana teman-teman? Mbak Afrilia ini belum ujian gelombang satu ya?
Gelombang dua.
Belum. Nanti ke gelombang dua ya. Oke. Okay. Jadi ini sambil latihan presentasi gitu ya. Oke. Okay. Bagaimana? Oke. Okay. Mungkin atau mungkin bisa sambil dicatat dulu ya. If you have questions or comments for your friend's presentation. Now let's continue to the next presenter. Mbak Adinda Eka sudah ada?
Yeah,
yes, sudah. Okay. Silakan Mbak. Yes, please.
Apakah sudah terlihat?
Oke, okay, ya. Masih proses, Mbak.
Sudah terlihat atau belum?
Oh. Baru muncul Adinda Eka Larasati has started screen sharing.
Sebentar.
Ini sebentar lagi.
Apakah sudah terlihat, Mem?
Yes, oke, okay, Mbak.
Oke.
Okay. Mbak, maaf itu ada suara-suara lain itu apa ya?
Maksudnya... Oh, maaf, maaf.
Mm-hmm.
Apakah suaranya yang lain mengganggu atau tidak?
Oke, udah sepi.
Sudah ya?
Ya, silakan, Mbak.
Oke, sebentar. Oke, bisa saya mulai sekarang, Men? Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ladies and gentlemen, in this special occasion, I am Arinda Ekawarasati, the student of English Education Department University PGRI Madiun. I would like to thank to the moderator who have given me an opportunity to present my article entitled Dissociative Identity Disorder, A Case of Frankie and Alice Movie. Next, let's begin with the background of the study. So, Dissociative Identity Disorder, or DID, becomes an interesting phenomenon in the movie for so many years since it described the people complexity of man mentality. The DID is characterized by the emergence of confusion that gives rise to two or more personalities. On the other hand, the DID is a rare psychiatric condition that affects only 1.5% of the world population. That means from 7.69 billion people, 119.4 million suffer from the DID. In the line with this beginning of the segment of this paragraph, it reflects that the production of movies telling story about the DID sufferer in Greece. This research will see the case in the movie as the case of society. Hence, it's based on the assumption that a movie becomes popular because it's reflected in their society. Next is the reason why the researcher used the object Frankie and Alice movie is because Frankie is based on a true story of Francine Lucinda Murdoch, a stripper in Los Angeles. In the American in the 1970s, Frankie also has obtained a high ranking on a traumatisociation.com, achieved some award as a mental health prison feature movie, and was screened at the Cannes Movie Festival in 2010. What's next? The recent question in this research is how is the relevance of the movie and the DID issue in American society? And the purpose of this research is to analyze the relevance of movie and the DID issue in American society. The researcher will use popular literature as the main topic for answer the question. And use the DID theory based on the DSM-5. For the method that the researcher used in this research, the researcher used a higher descriptive qualitative method, and the data source is the primary data from Frankie and Alice, and the secondary data is needed to support the primary data. It's come from theories, articles, journals, news, official website related to the topic of discussion, namely the DID and society. For the data collection in this research, the researcher uses documentary data. For the data analysis, the researcher uses a three step for analyzing the data. First is identifying, second is classifying the data, third is analyzing, describing, and explaining. Next is the result that the researcher conduct in this research. First, and this result is based on a cultural background. First is war bring people to the DID in Greece. The US Department of Veterans Affairs of VA has reported that somewhere between 10 and 15% of our post-traumatic stress. The researcher get the interpretation of the data as war has the considerably impact with the increasing number of people affected by mental illness, one of which is dissociative identity disorder. This is because many factors caused by war, such as trauma, violence, and other occur during the war. And many people believe that people with mental illness is dangerous and mentally unstable. This case is example of the people's stigma is the shooting incident on a civilian in the city of Flint, Florida, on Sunday, September 4, 2021, that killed 4 people and 1 critically. The suspect is an American affair and been diagnosed a mental illness. The next is public opinion and mental illness. Therefore, the general public does not fully understand disability and learn most of its knowledge from television and movie. Movie that misinterpret or depict it inaccurately create a stigma. Due to sensationalism, movie tend to dramatize and hype about crime, violence, and etc. to create more interesting stories. Meanwhile, according in a reality or in a reality that occur in a society, according to Dr. Sheldon, in a New York-based psychologist and psychoanalysis, said that many of his patients with DID are highly functioning before. From this data, the popular culture that exists in American today, the researcher concludes that the existence of movies with the topic of DID does not have much effect on the DID that occur in the society or in the environment. They tend to be interested only in watching the movies, but not to understand what and how people with DID are trying to fight it. This data from the Roper Center for Public Opinion Research says that 18% of Americans felt the stigma associated with mental illness is increased of 5%. The next result is the presence of movie as a popular literature portraying the ID. From the data from CNORG, of 1.5% of U.S. adults meet diagnostic criteria for DID. The presence of movie in human life today is considered to be increasingly important and equal to other media, in line with EPCA theory, which is the theory that the researcher used in this research, say that popular literature is the form of writing and movie is also competing to follow and in the development of the two is the lifestyle and the talk of the people. This is the reason why mental illness movies such as DID is well liked by many people. Examining the data from various research, DID is a common thing in America, but movie has portraying DID. The way it's portraying DID is not even accurate, and it might be shown as just a media tactic to get attention of the public and make the story more interesting. Next is the conclusion that the researcher concluded from this research is found out that many Americans suffer from mental illness, one of which is DID. DID has also become one of the talk in society because people have a curiosity about mental illness. About DID tendency are often misinterpreted and generalized by the media. The movie become a place to satisfy the audience curiosity about the ID and just solely as a place for entertainment and profit. And that's all for my presentation. Thank you.
Yes, okay, Mbak Adinda Eka, thank you. So how about the others? Do you have any questions or comments? Your topic of research reminds me of my own topic of speaking presentation when I was in my S1 study, Mbak. Jadi saya dulu ketika S1 pernah mengangkat topik DID ini juga, hanya saja waktu itu tokohnya yang suffer from DID adalah Carl May. So who is the character in the movie, Mbak, who suffer from DID?
Frankie. Ini dari based on a true story.
Okay, yes. Jadi dia menunjukkan DID-nya itu contohnya seperti apa, Mbak?
contohnya di ID menunjukkan alternya gitu. Saya yes. nanti menunjukkan yang di skripsi itu menunjukkan tipe-tipe di ID sama penyebab di ID yang diderita oleh Frankie itu sendiri.
No, I mean the symptoms. The symptoms.
Oh, the symptoms-nya,
yes.
Iya, yeah, iya. Yeah. The symptoms-nya itu amnesia di ID tadi sama kalau tidak di ID type A itu apa ya? Inter identity begitu. Jadi perubahan nada bicara, perubahan personality, yes.
Okay. So, do you mean that he can be different person?
Yeah. Okay. Dia have an alter, its name Alice, it's a white woman that racist, and one alter again is named Genius, is a child that is named Genius.
Okay. Oh, so Frankie and Alice actually the same person.
Yes, the same person. Okay. The yes. people is Frankie and have alter Alice and Genius.
Yes, oke. Okay. Ya, topik seperti ini memang banyak diangkat ya. Jadi salah movie juga ada juga seperti ini. Oke, okay, very interesting. Thank you, Mbak. Bagaimana teman-teman yang lain? Apakah ada? Oke, okay, maybe you can save your question or comment later on. Or maybe you can also drop in the chat box. Let's continue to Devi Tama.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Are you ready, Mbak Devi Tama?
Yeah, ma'am.
Let me take the stage. Try to make your presentation not more than 10 minutes, okay?
Sudah muncul belum?
Belum. Sebentar. Masih proses sepertinya. Belum bisa, Mbak.
Sudah itu.
Sudah, Anda klik share screen. Tapi di sini belum muncul.
Oh, bentar.
You want to find the apa tadi, Mbak? The main one.
Yeah, elocutionary act, ma'am.
So how about the others? Yes? Belum ada? Okay, mungkin bisa disimpan dulu ya nanti. Please participate ya. Participate actively for the others. Oke, Mbak Devi sudah siap?
Ya, ini saya coba lagi. Sudah.
Yes, oke, okay, Mbak.
Iya.
Silakan.
Gak usah dibesarkan ya, Mem.
Ya, oke, okay. Bisa.
Oke, okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
In this era of globalization, we often encounter or even experience using two language in one conversation. It can be Japanese, Indonesian, Indonesian, and English, and etc. That's why the researcher you choose this title for the research. That is code switching used by Agnes Mo. Go International, Agnes Mo selalu bangga mewakili Indonesia at Daniel Mananta YouTube channel. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Devi Tama Parsela, a speaker in this seminar and also the researcher. Next is language is used by human in all activities of life. Keras convey his idea that language is a system of sound symbols produced by human speech tools that allows people to communicate with one and another. Oral, written, or even gestural communication are all options. Communication is very important for human life. That's because basically humans are social creatures who need each other. Effective communication can help people in various things that happen in everyday life so that it can strengthen the relationship between one individual and another. In this era of globalization, many people have the ability to use multiple languages. A person who can speak more than one language is called a bilingual or multilingual person. This phenomenon causes people to use two or more languages, and then the use of two or more languages is commonly called code switching in sociolinguistics.
Tapi ki Zoom-nya ki mikrofonnya rusak, aku cuma go
headset. Aku is the subject of this research because Aksmo often collaborates with foreign seniors such as Chris Brown. She also has a song that uses code switching in the lyrics. Agnes is one of many singers that use code switching. And this analysis will analyze the dominant type of code switching by using Wardell's theory and reasons of code switching by using Hoffman's theory that used by Agnes Mo in her utterances in the video entitled Go International, Agnes Mo Selalu Bangga Mewakili Indonesia. And this video was chosen because this video has been watched by more than 400,000 viewers and got more than 14 likes. Next is the research problems. First one is what type of code switching that occurred in Daniel Mananta's video entitled Go International, Agnes Mo Selalu Bangga Mewakili Indonesia, used by Agnes Mo, and what are the reasons why Agnes Mo used code switching in her utterance by using Hoffman theories. And the research purpose is, the first is to describe the type that used by, the type of code switching that used by Agnes Mo, and the second one is what are the reasons that use why Agnes Mo used code switching in her utterance. Next, the significance of the study, the theoretical significance is the result of this research capable to increase the knowledge in sociolinguistics, especially about code switching. And the practical significance, the first one is to the English teacher. This research result can be increase the knowledge about bilingualism and also code switching the teacher because as the teachers often switch their language to give clear explanation to their student. Next is the practical significance to the student. The result of this research can be capable of make student deeply understand about sociolinguistic knowledge. And for the further researcher, hope this study can be increase the knowledge about code switching and also can be references to the further researcher. Next is the theoretical framework. First one is code switching. Myers and Scotton 2006 says that the practice of using two different types of language while having a single discussion is known as code switching. From Wardell's theory, Wardell divides code switching into situational and metaphorical type of code switching. And from Hoffman's theory, Hoffman said that there are 10 causes for code switching. There are talking about particular topics, quoting somebody else, being empathic about something, express solidarity, interjection, repetition, intentions of clarifying the speech content for interlocutor, expressing group identity to soften or strengthen request or command because of lexical need, and to exclude other people when a comment is intended for only a limited audience. The research method in this research is First, this research uses content analysis design. Content analysis design is a research tool that focuses on the actual content and internal features of medium. The subject of this research and the source of data of this research is the utterance of Agnes Mo from the video titled Go International, Agnes Mo Selalu Bangga Mewakili Indonesia in Daniel Mananta YouTube channel, the upload at 9 January 2020. And to support in gathering the data, the researcher also used documentary method, which is the researcher will transcribe the data. And after the data is collecting, the researcher classify the data according to this table. The first one is type of code switching used by Agnes Mo. There are situational code switching and metaphorical code switching. And to the second research problems is the reason of code switching used by Agnes Mo based on Hoffman theory. There are 10 reasons that are conveyed by Hoffman. Next is type of code switching used by Agnes Mo. The data found from Agnes Mo's utterance that containing code switching from the video entitled Go International, Agnes Mo Selalu Bangga Mewakili Indonesia amount to 55 data. And the results show that type of code switching used by Agnes Mo are four data including in situational code switching, 51 data including metaphorical code switching. Therefore, the dominant type of code switching used by Agnes Mo in Go International, Agnes Mo Selalu Bangga Mewakili Indonesia is metaphorical code switching. Next is the reasons why Agnes Mo used code switching. The data amount to 55 data. And the results show that the reasons for code switching used by Agnes Mo in the video is 34 data contain intention of clarifying the speech content for interlocutor, 17 data contain quoting someone else, and 4 data contain to soften or strengthen request or comment, 2 data contain interjection, and 1 data contain repetition. In the conclusion is for the first research question, the results of the analysis show that the dominant type of code switching used by Agnes Mo in the video is metaphorical code switching, and the dominant reason used by Agnes Mo is intention of clarifying the speech content for interlocutor. From the research results, there are still many possibilities for further research on the topic of code switching in the future, because the study only analyzed about the type and the reasons code switching. Therefore, the researcher suggests for those who are interested in this topic to analyze the impact of using code switching on people's attitudes and perception about code switching. There are many possibilities to sample Indonesian, English, or etc. code switching. Research not only from podcast or video, but also from other media such as radio, magazine, advertisement, reality show, social media, even a classroom, and many more. Thus, there will be some variation in future research about code switching. That's the I can say about my research. Thank you so much for the attention and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you Mbak Devi Tamal for the presentation. So how the other participants? Do you have questions or comments about Agnes Mo? Okay, Agnes Mo. So it is not the that's the not the video clip, yeah. Not the song clip. Bukan video klip lagunya ya, yang ada yang ada analisis.
In this research is Uterance by Agnes Mo, as spoken by Agnes Mo in the video titled Go International, Agnes Mo selalu bangga mewakili Indonesia in Daniel Mananta YouTube channel.
Okay, so it is a kind of apa podcast talk begitu ya?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, thank you. Why are you interested in this kind of analysis? Kenapa kok memilih videonya Agnes Mo?
Agnes Mo often collaborate with foreign language, foreign singers such as Chris Brown. So I think Agnes Mo use so much code switching in their utterance every day.
Okay. How about you yourself? Do you like her songs?
I don't listen Agnes Mo.
Oh, you don't listen Agnes Mo? Okay. Yes. So what do you listen?
I don't really like songs. I like watch some dramas.
Oh, okay. So you don't really like songs. Okay then. Okay. Bagaimana teman-teman yang lain? Ada yang mau disampaikan? Do you have questions or comments? Sudah ada. Okay then. Bisa kita lanjutkan ya, nggak apa-apa ya?
Yeah, yeah. Thank you, Mbak Devi.
Yes, welcome. Thank you, Mbak Devi. Okay then, we come to the next presenter. That will be Mbak Devi, Milania.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Are you ready, Mbak Devi? You may take the stage, Mbak Devi. Ini sepertinya masih proses.
Baru?
Yes, okay.
Sudah lihat, Mom?
Ya.
Okay, good morning. Good morning, kita dan semuanya. So, I'm Devina Lania from University of Gary Madiun. As a researcher, I would like to present my article about intellectual growth in the end of talking about theory. So let's go first into chapter 1 about the kind of studies. So what are some of the discussed in the first series for a reason? In our language, we need to know various kind of vocabulary. What of vocabulary that can be used in conventional samples and expressing feeling? Phonetics is learning. According to the narrative, the words are used to describe a certain feeling in high growth vision. People all over the world know that swearing is bad act that reflects their behavior. Therefore, servers can shock and disturb others. It is wise to speak to people or open chats negatively. But sometimes, unlike language in general, servers are not taught in specific environments, such as families and schools, but conference and something related to spreading words. But even though servers are categorized as bad and should be avoided, many people swear as part of self-expression. Sometimes it can be used to show or show emotion, but sometimes it just does not have to be emotional. And therefore, understanding why people swear is so very important to create understanding of the context to give response appropriately. Although in general, servers are offensive and harmful, they do not always mean that it's in all contexts and situations. Some of them can be used for other purposes. It can be added to pay for jobs or stories of imagination or even substitutes for physical aggression. And the media, it was used by works of series, films, and television. The series used by the researchers as an object is the end of the talking word. Originally, I aired on channel 43. The research could critically quote reviews and become a hit when it finally premiered on Netflix in 2018. And the series indeed become a worldwide cult phenomenon. The series tells the story of two young teenagers, James and Alyssa, who run away from home to avoid their family. The reason why behind the selection of the series is as follows. It contains a lot of words spoken by teenagers. And the series is considerable as an object because the hero of 17 years old who said a lot of words. And this phenomenon is the of teenagers who use swear words is very interesting to his mind. In 2016, not this issue. Understanding why people swear can help students distinguish between dangerous and normal situations, so they do not misuse them. This is what kind of swear words they use and under which condition they use it. The research can also be a reference for teenagers learning as their single second language, first state of feeling through language. And the scope of the limitation, and then focus on the social linguistic approach in the African word first series. The teacher will figure out the meaning of the word because it literally does not the category of the words as a by the main character. And there is this research use understand and start your concept as a main theory to respond to the first formulated problem about swearing categories as they are relevant to be implemented in investigating their work included in the series. So that's why the researcher formulated for a situation, okay, what are the types portrayed by main characters in the series Diana at work. So for the method, the researcher used qualitative research analysis data. The objective of the researcher are to identify the types of using servers. Meanwhile, the subject is the dialogues from the series, which contains their words. In this picture, there are two data needed. Those are primary data and secondary data. Primary data of the research is the transcript of the dialogue between James and Alyssa that contains their words. Then transcript was taken from the internet, and the researcher collected this their words data and then identified them by grouping them into types according to evolution theory. And secondary data comes from journals, clinical, and previous studies. The redaction from Mars and Haberman. The first technique is the detection. The detection refers to selecting, focusing, summarizing, abstracting, and transforming the data into a short note. In this situation, the data is from a video from the questions of and transcription of the dialogue by the main characters in the analysis of the word. In this step, the researcher analyzed the data by watching the series several times to check the data by reading the transcription. Next, the researcher selects the dialogue that contains the words in the series to be analyzed. After that, the researcher categorizes the data using understanding theory. The second one, that is this way. And the last is conclusion drawing. After finishing analyzing and explaining data, the last step is conclusion drawing. In this step, researcher conclusions this research that has been done by based on the theory used for the two followed by several 11 previous studies. This all. So as you can see in table 2.1, syntax of type of server. In the study, this auxiliary server is the most spoken word. The auxiliary server is not intended for other people and not to blame the patient has no exact meaning. The researcher both explore showing the similar findings such as the previous study by Samirin, Ashidin, and Yanti, Prayudas, Nazen, and Generta, and Irawan. They found that auxiliary swear words most appear in the movie. Yes. The research proved that the series is also included in the tools of film that have the most absolute word types according to Anderson, which means that absolute word is the most preferred swear word by film or script writers in the dialogue to support the character's goal. This is number two, comparison of servers for the same interest. Alpha and James as the main object of research to save a lot of servers. The researcher found that age is one of the factors that make Alpha and James as the major specific Danish code save servers in almost everything in the series. Now, what about 2015? In study through the search of age, social media page, MySpace, show the result that young users have more servers than other users. And this phenomenon is explained by Nurulina and Jamal 2014. That nature use swear words as a form of releasing their negative feelings, especially anger and frustration. This is in line with the feelings of Alicia and James, which are dominated by feelings of anger and fear. Then they express it by swearing. And compared to James, Alicia as a woman becomes the main character using the most swear words in the series. This finding goes against the stereotype of using taboo words are included in the masculine things and do not fit into women's language based on norms and stereotypes. This stereotype exists in society and assumes that compared to women, men speak more swear words. But this stereotype is generally believed that men speak more swear words than women related to the logical, where men have a testosterone, which is known as aggressive hormone, and is often associated with swearing. Plus, this stereotype grows from women in the past who have less rights and were not allowed to talk about certain things. This continues to develop in society today. Sometimes women are still debated about what words can and cannot be said. Those facts are reacted by both linguistic beliefs who get misconceptions regarding language based on personal opinions of norms. This belief is not something scientific, it is just thought and assumption and based on speculation, prejudice, and everyday conversation. And this is started to change as many studies have been conducted to prove that females were more than males. More recent studies before that stereotype is no longer fit with the current phenomenon. Females are getting familiar with offensive words, then swearing becomes part of their language. Alyssa is one of the many female characters created by men, namely Charles S. Portman, who broke away from the stereotype of society. And considering the finding that Alyssa has said a lot of actual swear words in the study, it is found that Alyssa comes from broken home. Her father left her when she was little, and her mother got married to a freak guy that makes her sick in her adult and has a personality that is intolerant and always looked down on others. That is why she short and always expressed her feeling openly without thinking about others. This says a lot of their work. This phenomenon in which Sahib for the in his book children. In his book, children from broken home families mostly have attachment disorder. Children with attachment disorder tend to feel insecure. They perceive adults as neither trustworthy nor reliable. Alyssa then suffers attachment disorder. Okay, back to result number one. There is no humorous word. Moreover, there is no humorous word found in their language. Humorous is an expressive of an ability to be funny or to be amusing. The researcher did not find humorous swear words throughout the conversation spoken by Alyssa and James. The conversation was dominated by dark comedy, the pronunciation is not necessarily humorous vibe. Most of emotions that occur are worry and anger, and emotion that is expressed when they are faced with a series in an unexpected way. Okay, back to talk number three. As you can see, that what is the word that Alyssa and James referring the word.
But 2 more minutes, yeah.
Okay. Alyssa and James in referring to manually use the word fuck. The sexual consequence that young people and teenagers get even the room patterns are that fuck more frequently than people from other age. This is because the reason that as teenagers they trying to prove the natural way swearing. Alyssa thought that she has grown up and running away from home and going to find her biological father. And James will do so. This psychopath and the entertainment his big father who decide for Alyssa to kill her with excuse that we have her to find her father. And the following origin of the word fuck. To reveal why such word says off, fuck is mother of all words. According to Sally Johnson, it is short, effective, and gets the root of creation. The word fuck, starting from a word that has not been spoken from decades to the word that has appeared under time in different forms, and that perhaps becomes the most even the most evolved server. The last one is compression. Based on the analysis, the researchers discovered observers that are read by Alyssa and James in the University of Australia. It is known that three or four types of servers used by Alyssa and James in the series of Australian servers are the most common types in the series, which is often used servers in sizes slickers meaning. Therefore, age, gender, and broken home are factors that make Alyssa and James vary. From all the best servers, they say the word fuck appears the most. Moreover, it is one of the most interesting words that can be described pain and pleasure, like the feeling they have through a decision. Charles S. Furman, as an author of the series, is put fuck in almost all of the main characters they like to support their characters. This is end of my introduction of my about my video. Thank you for the time. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Ya, yes, Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Mbak Devi Milania. Okay, so how about you, the others? Do you have questions or comments? How many episodes did you watch, Mbak, for this series?
Total 16 dari 2 series.
16 episodes.
Yes, 16 episodes.
So you watched the episode. How do you watch the series, Mbak?
From Netflix.
On Netflix, yes. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Swear words. Wow. Okay. Yes. Thank you, Mbak Devi. How about the others? Do you have questions or comments? Sudah. Kita lanjutkan ya. The next will be Mbak Agil. So, how Mbak Agil, are you ready? Mbak Agil, mikrofonnya sudah dinyalakan. I can't hear your voice, Mbak. Belum bisa, Mbak Agil. Bagaimana? Lagi bisa? Atau mungkin mau yang lain dulu? Ya, gimana lagi? Kita sambil diperbaiki apa di ini dulu soalnya. Kita pindah yang lain dulu ya, Pak Agil ya. Oke. Okay. Elma Lianita. Elma Lianita atau Karisma? Ya, silakan. Halo, Mbak Elma Lianita. Mbak Elma, siapkah? Atau Mbak Karisma dulu? Oh ya, oke. Okay. Silahkan Mbak Agil, nggak apa-apa. Mau sekarang atau Mbak Karisma dulu? Mbak Karisma, sudah? Siap? Yes? Oke. Okay. Ya, oke. Okay. Mbak Karisma dibantu Mbak Adinda, nggak apa-apa. Yes, oke. Okay. Berarti setelah ini Mbak Agil ya. Mbak Agil siap-siap ya.
Ya, ma'am.
Oke. Okay. Ya, silakan Mbak Karisma.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you for the time that you've given to me. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Karisma NPM 16, I will present about my research. Next slide. Okay. The economy of the study. Writing is the most complicated language skill that students must learn to express the ideas, thoughts, and feelings in writing form. This is because the student needs good skill and habits such as writing motivation and grammar rules to become competent writers. Therefore, institutional high school students must be able to put writing skill as a part of the teaching and learning process because writing skills are one of the most important aspects for students. Writing skill refers to the ability to create a graphic system such as letter, word, and certain language phrases used in writing communication to help readers understand information. Writing skill, according to Dumay, this skill is critical for students as a communication tool that cannot be separated from the language learning process and allow students to express their thoughts, feelings, and ideas writing. Students have difficulty expressing their ideas and thoughts in writing. According to Wafa et al., one of the most problems faced by students in writing is the lack of opportunity to write their ideas. This condition often stresses the student so that they feel more difficult in writing. Therefore, writing is not an easy activity since it requires more practice to become good writing. Learning media is an effective and practical tool that can help learning process so that learning can take place smoothly and freshly. Learning media is an effective and practical tools that can help learning process so that learning can take place smoothly and freshly. According to Haridin et al., state that in the learning process in school, learning media is an important thing in the classroom. Teaching media is used to assist teacher in delivering lessons or case to communicate the teacher's concept of a particular material to student understanding. Diary is one of the media that can be used in the learning to write, especially writing experience text. According to Klimova, that diaries are also called notebook where people can write whatever they want, such as thoughts, ideas, feeling, or experience. This can support the condition needed by students to improve their enthusiasm and writing skill, especially when learning to develop vocabulary and indirectly learning to write sentence well. Next slide. This is the previous study. In this study, the researcher found inspiration from previous studies by discussing similar topics regarding teaching writing. One research is conducted by Hidayah. Next slide. This is the purpose of the study. The researcher want to know whether students who are taught using diaries have better writing skill than students who are taught using conventional learning. Next slide. This is the research method. Place the research in SMKN Satu Madiun and the time February until July, and the research using quantitative research and the population. The research, all students of class 10 SMKN Satu Madiun, in the sample 10 teknik listrik 1 and 10 teknik listrik 2, sampling technique, random sampling, and the collecting data is writing test, pre-test, and post-test, in the data analysis, homogeneity test, normality test, and hypothesis testing. Next slide. Next slide, please. Okay. This is the descriptive statistic pretest. The statistic of the data of pretest above explain that amount of student in each class is 36 students. The mean score of experimental class is 48.53, while the score of control class is 40.35. The median score of experimental class 46.50, while the score of control class is 38.38. The modus score of experimental class is 54, while the score of control class is 32.
The minimum score. Two more minutes, Emma.
Okay.
Two more minutes.
Okay. Based on the data above, it can be seen that the score of mean and model of experimental class are higher than the score of the control class. The post-test. Based off the table show that based on data above, it can be seen that the score of mean and mode of experimental class are higher than the score of the control class. Next slide. The normality test. The table above tells the normality test of the post-test data from experimental class and control class. The table above. It can be concluded that the score of post-test data from both places are normally distributed, so independent sample test can be done, and the homogeneity test. The table above show the significant value or rating score is 3348. And it can be based on the score, the significant value is 3348. It's more than higher. It can be conclude that the data from this sample has equal variance or homogeneous. So the variance of post-test data of experimental class and control class are homogeneous. Next slide.
Okay, what if we directly go to conclusion?
Conclusion, like the last slide. Yes. The conclusion, the result of the study showed that there is a significant effect on writing skill using diary media. Diary writing activities can improve student skill in writing record. Writing a diary can make students more interested in writing record text material. With diary writing activities, teacher can stimulate students to write down their experience on paper. Diary writing activities are interesting and motivate students to learn to write English easily. That's all my research presentation. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, thank you Mbak Karisma. Then we come to the next presenter, Mbak Agil. Yeah. So how, Mbak Agil? Yes. Are you ready?
Yes.
Yeah. Silakan, Mbak. Berarti Mbak Agil ini will be the last presenter ya. Mbak Amalianita, Ersa, Fauzia will be participants ya, benar.
Apakah sudah terlihat, Mbak?
Gimana?
Apakah sudah terlihat?
Halo, gimana?
Apakah sudah terlihat?
Belum. Boleh, Mbak. Oke, proses lagi sepertinya. Loadingnya agak lama. Oke, Mbak Agil, nggak apa-apa, bisa langsung di ini aja sambil nunggu screen-nya muncul. Bisa sama dimulai.
Background study of this article is a song lyric arises meaning and interpretation. Song lyrics have an important role in a song, even though lyrics act as the second element in a song. The study of the intended meaning by a singer or speaker is known as pragmatic. According to Yuli 1996, stated that pragmatic is a study about meaning as communication by a speaker or writer and interpreted by a listener or reader. The next is the elimination of this study. This study focus on the type of texts that used by the songwriter and used 5 songs in the first album, Sour, by Olivia Rodrigo, using the theory of Alan Kurz, 2000. Next is research question. Research question is, what are the kind of texts used in song lyrics of Sour album? Next is purpose of study. The purpose is to identify the kind of texts that are used in lyrics Sour album. And next, research methods. The first is type of research. This research is descriptive qualitative research. And second is data sort. This research using document lyrics of Sour album. Then the data using of 5 songs in our album, which are driver entitled Driver License, Traitor, Deja Vu, Good For You, and Happier. The third is data collecting technique. The data collecting technique is used documentation technique. And the last is technique analyzing data. For analyzing the data, use data condensation. Second is data display, and the last conclusion or drawing conclusion. The next is results. The first is person deaxis. Person deaxis involves basically the speaker known as the first person, the address known as the second person, and other significant participant in the speech situation, neither speaker or hearer. These are known as third person. And there is a table of the kind of person deaxis in our album. In song Driver License, the person deaxis is the first person deaxis is I, me, we, and my. The researchers find in second is you, and the third person deaxis is she, they, them. In the Deja Vu songs, the first person deaxis is I, me, I, my, our, and we. And the second person deaxis is you and your. The third is she, her, and it. And in song Happier, in first person deaxis is I, my, me, we, our, and mine. And second person deaxis is you and your. The third person deaxis is she and her. The fourth in traitor, first person deaxis is I, me, we. The second person deaxis is you and your. And the third is she, her, and it. In Good For You, first person deaxis is I, me, we, and my. The second person deaxis is you, and the third is she and it. And the next is spatial deaxis. Spatial deaxis concern the encoding of location relative to the participation of the song. And there is the table of the kind of spatial deaxis in our album. In Driver License, the spatial deaxis is the suburb in the white cars, front yards, sidewalks, in the traffic. In Traitor, spatial deaxis is there and in the bed. In song Happier, there is no spatial deaxis. In Deja Vu, spatial deaxis is Malibu and there. In Good For You, there is spatial deaxis is there and my bedroom. The next is temporal deaxis. Temporal deaxis involves the encoding of the time relative to the speaker. And there is table of the kind of temporal deaxis in our album. In Driver License, temporal deaxis is last week, now, and today. In Deja Vu, temporal deaxis is now. In Happier, the temporal deaxis is one ago. In Traitor, the temporal deaxis is 2 weeks. In Good For You, the temporal deaxis is couple weeks, now and the night. And the next is social deaxis. Social deaxis is an expression that serves to show that the position of the reference in the social status scale and relative intimacy with the speaker. And there is the and there is the table of the kind of social dexes in our album. In driver's license, the social dexes is that blonde girl, my friends, and babe. In deja vu, the social dexes is actress and uptown girl. In happier, social dexes is baby. In traitor, the social dexes is friends. And in good for you, the social dexes is baby. And the last is discourse dexes. Discourse dexes refers to such matter as the use of this to point to the future discourse element. And there is the appeal of the kind of discourse dexes in our album. In driver license, discourse dexes is but an I and the in deja vu, the discourse dexes is dead and soul. In happier, the discourse dexes is but and soul. In traitor, the discourse dexes is but and soul. And the last is in good for you, the discourse dexes is but and the last is conclusion. Based on the result of the analysis in the previous discussion, the researcher concluded that the five songs that became the data, most all of them had five types of dexes based on the Alanger's theory, which are person dexes, spatial dexes, temporal dexes, social dexes, and discourse dexes. The most dexes type that used by the songwriter is person dexes. Meanwhile, the researcher did not find spatial dexes in the song entitled Happier. With this research, it is hoped that it will make it easier for listeners or readers to understand the context or meaning of the songs. And that is my presentation. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, thank you very much, Mbak Agil, for the presentation. How about the others? Do you have questions or comments for this presentation? Okay, so some suggestion for you ya. Yeah? Please pay attention to some pronunciation. Okay. Jadi ini kan ceritanya anda semua ya. This is for all of you. Jadi kan ceritanya ini sambil seperti latihan ujian ya berarti ya. Yeah, so there are some vocabulary needs to revise for the presentation, okay? Result, writing, written, study, ya. Jadi beberapa dari Anda masih ada yang kepleset, ya, sleep. Ya, sleep on the tongue, some of you study, maybe soto. Yes, of course you have to revise your pronunciation. Okay, jadi nanti ketika Anda sudah ini semuanya masih di sini ya. All of you still here, okay? Jadi ketika Anda when the time is come, when the real time is come, Anda sudah siap dengan presentasi dengan penampilan dan speaking skill yang mumpuni. With very good speaking skill, okay. So good luck for your next project, yeah. For your next project. Now we will close this meeting directly in break room, yeah. In this break room, so you don't have to return to the main room. Later on, there will be questionnaire shared to you to answer. So you have to answer the questionnaire regarding to today's meeting, okay? So nanti akan ada di share ke Anda ya. Okay, thank you very much for today's presentation. Let's give applause for all of you. Yeah. Okay. Have a good afternoon, everyone. Good luck to all of you, ya, seperti pesan speaker and keynote speaker Anda tadi, tetap berlatih, tetap belajar, ya. Jadi untuk meningkatkan skill Anda. Okay, jadi I will close today's meeting. Thank you very much once again for joining today's presentation or joining today's virtual meeting. Kita foto dulu sekali lagi ya, yang tidak pakai presentasi. Okay, would you please turn the camera on, all of you? Okay. Masih ada di sini semua, Kak? Ya, okay. Mbak Devi Tama, okay, Salma, Karisma, Helma, Fauzia. Mbak Devi Tama nggak nyala kameranya. Oke, siap ya. 1, 2, 3. Yes. Thank you everybody. Oh, sekali lagi. Oke, thank you everybody. See you again. Good luck for your thesis examination ya.
Mau tanya.
Yes, apa?
Untuk itu sidangnya kan tanggal 25, 26, 27.
Thank you, ma'am.
Nah, itu jadwalnya gimana, ma'am?
Belum dibuat. Sabar. Kemungkinan akan 2 hari.
Ya. Oh, ya. Yeah.
Yang penting sekarang persiapan dan belajar. Oke. Thank you. Have a good afternoon, everyone. Goodbye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.